here to remember to not remember if I am sick. I'm here to film my review of the unbecoming. My last name is really bad again. The unbecoming of Mara Dyer by Michelle Hodgkinson. So. Mara Dyer doesn't think life can get any stranger. She wakes up from a coma in hospital with no memory of how she got there or the bizarre incident accident that caused the death of her best friends and her boyfriend, yet left her mysteriously unharmed. The doctor suggests that starting off in a new city, a new school, will be good for her and just let her the memories gradually come back on their own. But Mara's new start is anything but comforting. She sees the faces of her dead friends everywhere, and when she suddenly begins to see other people's deaths right before they happen, Mara wonders whether she's going crazy, and if dealing with all this wasn't enough, Mara is sure the most beautiful boy she has ever seen can't seem to leave her alone. But as her life unravels around her, Mara can't help wonder if no one has another agenda altogether. I gave this book. A 5 out of 5 stars. The Unbecoming of Mara Dyer had a huge amount of build-up and hype prior to publishing. And one of these cases of these hype books is that you're immediately waiting for it to falter. But fortunately, I can't say that it did. One of my favourite things about the book was Mara's narrative style. If you're going to be stuck inside someone's head for 400 pages, I have to keep you entertained. Mara didn't disappoint in that department. Throughout the book, there was an abundance of one-liners and witty repartee. Apart from a rough outline, I didn't know what to expect with this book as far as the plot was concerned. It was definitely suspenseful and had many creepy scenes, especially in the first half of the book where Mara is still grappling with wondering whether she's insane, all of which made the story incredibly gripping. I loved how, mainly to begin with as a reader, you're just as confused as Mara when it comes to her fantasy. The negatives, when I was initially very annoyed, a very common mistake in YA with the use of the term British accent, when Mara was just describing it now, sure. Smiling and mysterious love interest of the story, but hallelujah, now I correct Mara and I couldn't help doing my happy dance at Michelle Hodgkin for knowing the difference. She received a big thumbs up just for that, but on a more serious note, the only thought that I could find was that as the story progressed, the strange occurrences loosened. I know this would have made the plot crowded, but when something bad did happen, its description wasn't as scary or hard-hitting as it was early in the book, although that was mainly because Mara was beginning to understand what was truly going on. As far as the romance goes, I was surprised by the amount there was. No one is typically a desirable character, the bad boy who's masking his true personality. Sweet, kind and caring, I loved how Mara and Noah's relationship started. The tension and the fighting, that's always my favourite part, and I will be interested to see how it continues in the next book. The book leaves on a quite mysterious cliffhanger that I can't wait to have answers to. I couldn't help but devour this book. It was one of those compulsive reads where I found time playing without me realising. Not unlike Mara herself, and so I have to say it had me hooked. A compulsively gripping novel that I think everyone will enjoy. And as I said, I give this book a 5 out of 5 stars. So I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!